Who is the chef? Knight with a heat transfer mind, a loyalist spy who left his family behind. Army commander through challenge and strife, disproved a man's theory and then married his wife in Massachusetts, a student walking 10 miles to school. Worked with a merchant and learned science was cool. His wealthy widowed wife gave him status, no doubt, but all of that changed when the war had broke out. He angered a mob by being loyal to George, fled across the world with a new life to forge. He was knighted and decided to hide out near Munich, got a job at the army and designed a new tunic. Needed a lot, and he needed the labor. Enlisted the poor, he became their great savior. Someone had to feed them, he decided to look, brought in the potato, and wrote a cookbook. After making sure all their bellies were full, he heard about caloric and he thought it was bull. So he got him a cannon and a grinder to smooth it, showed that heat comes from motion and not from a fluid. But he also invented, tinkered and toiled, invented a coffee pot, furnace and boiler, a fireplace, kitchen range, thermal underwear. He did a lot right, but he was wrong about air. A heat transfer pioneer you might not have heard, Sir Benjamin Thompson, also known as Count Rumsford. He was born in the year 1753, lived 61 years, but forever in history.
Now we will discuss the meaning behind these lyrics and teach you a bit about our chosen heat transfer pioneer. Our heat transfer pioneer is Sir Benjamin Thompson, also known as Count Rumsford. He was born in Woburn, Massachusetts on March 26, 1753 and died on August 21, 1814. Thompson showed an early interest in education, walking 10 miles to nearby Cambridge to attend lectures at Harvard College. At 13, he worked with a merchant where he met many well-educated people who introduced him to science. He took an interest in heat transfer and started conducting his own experiments. Thompson eventually married a wealthy widow named Sarah Walker, who used her connections with the governor to secure him a position as a major with the New Hampshire militia. Thompson was a loyalist and wanted to remain under British rule during the American Revolutionary War. He tried to recruit other loyalists to help fight for the British, which made him very unpopular. He was attacked at his home by an angry mob and forced to abandon his wife and child to flee to Britain. There, he fed the British information about the American forces. During the war, he conducted studies on the force of gunpowder, which earned him a reputation as a scientist. He was knighted by King George in 1784 and afterwards decided to move to Bavaria in Germany. Thompson had a few important experiments. He devised a way to find the specific heat of a material experimentally, but published it too late. He also studied fur, wool, and feathers to find out why they were good insulators, and correctly realized that it was because they trapped air to prevent convection. Unfortunately, he took his results too far by suggesting that air and other fluids were perfect insulators that could not transfer heat by conduction. He ended up being wrong about this.
Thompson's most important contribution to heat transfer was his disproval of caloric theory. Caloric theory was introduced in the late 18th century and stated that there was an invisible weightless fluid called caloric that was responsible for all heat transfer. This theory stated that the more a caloric substance had, the hotter it would be. Caloric was thought to be self-repelling and thus would flow naturally from hot substances to cold ones. The theory also said that caloric could not be created or destroyed, and that there was a finite amount of it in the universe. This theory explained why a hot cup of tea in a cold room would cool down. Caloric would travel from the hot cup to the room over time. Thompson didn't agree with this explanation. He had noticed from his time in the military that grinding the inside of a cannon produced a lot of heat. He set up an experiment where he grinded a cannon in water and was able to produce enough heat to boil the water in 2 hours. He showed that no material had entered the system and that the metal shavings that had come off of the cannon had the same properties as the cannon metal, and thus could not have lost any caloric. It thus appeared that the caloric would have to be formed out of nothing to create the observed heat. Thompson also showed that an unlimited amount of heat could be generated from this method, which would require an unlimited generation of caloric. Thus, the caloric theory could not be true. Instead, Thompson argued, a rival theory to the caloric theory, kinetic heat transfer, must be right. Heat must be created by microscopic motion in a substance, which was being transmitted by the motion of the grinder. This paved the way for the modern kinetic theory of heat transfer used today. An interesting historical side note to Thompson's disproval of the caloric theory is that a French chemist, Antoine Lavoisier, was one of the biggest proponents of caloric theory. After Lavoisier was beheaded in the French Revolution, Thompson, who had just disproved Lavoisier's theory, married Lavoisier's widow. The marriage only lasted 3 years. Aside from his experiments, Thompson was also an inventor. He came up with a drip coffee pot, the first commercially available kitchen range, and a double boiler. He also invented an improvement for kiln surfaces used in the production of quicklime, which made them burn more efficiently. One of his most famous inventions was the Rumsford fireplace. Before Thompson, fireplaces had two major design flaws. First, the fire was placed at the back of the fireplace and partially covered by brick, which reduced the view factor between the flame and the room. Since the main method of heat transfer for a fireplace is radiation, this meant a lot of heat was being wasted. Secondly, the smoke from the fireplace was designed to be carried up the chimney only by buoyant forces due to the smoke being hotter and thus less dense than the surrounding air. The problem was that when the fire was first lit, the smoke didn't have time to heat up and would be the same temperature and density as the air. This meant the smoke would not rise up in the chimney, but instead filled people's homes. Thompson created a better fireplace named the Rumsford fireplace. To fix the low view factor, Thompson filled the back of his fireplace with bricks, forcing the fire to come out into the room and radiate more heat. He also made the back of the fireplace sloped so that hot back wall of the fireplace would have a higher view factor with the room. Both these changes made the fireplace radiate heat more efficiently. To fix the smoke issue, Thompson redesigned the chimney so outside air would create a dynamic pressure to suck smoke up the chimney. This kept the smoke out of people's homes and also improved circulation so that the fire had better access to fresh oxygen, which allowed the flame to burn cleaner and hotter. Thompson's improved fireplace design was soon used all over London.
One interesting project Thompson worked on was improving the clothing of soldiers in Germany. He realized Long John-style underwear would be warmer for soldiers, but couldn't find any manufacturers who wanted to make it. He decided to enlist poor beggars in the city to make his Long Johns, but realized that he needed to feed his workforce cheaply. At the time, Europeans still didn't trust the potato, but Thompson realized it was perfect for his needs. He studied the science of nutrition and published a cookbook full of recipes for nutritious and filling meals. Through this weird chain of events, a man whose primary area of study was heat transfer ended up popularizing the potato in Germany and writing a cookbook that advanced nutritional sciences. These are our references. Thanks for watching.